What you will do if any team member in a scrum team is reluctant in following the scrum process?
Now, this is something is when I run my agile coaching class, we get this question all the time, and it's a reality. It's a reality in most of the scrum teams that they have at least one or two members who are very resistive, and many times these members are quite influential members. They are good in their technology and all those things. So first thing is, especially for an interview point of view, you need to bring up a story. You tell, okay, I had a once in a scrum team, this was a person XYZ, he was doing this, he has been working from these many days and all those things, and he was reluctant in handling that and doing scrum. So then you come up with a whole story. Because see, if the one person has done two, three projects, the probability of encountering such incident is pretty high. So you need to come up with a story where you say that, yes, I also faced it. That's the first thing. Now, the second thing is how you dealt with the story. Yeah. And you can also keep tentative in your dealing. You can say that once I have handled it in this particular way, this is not the only way, because not every person is same. Yeah. So first you create a character, and you need to solve a problem for that character. And also keep in mind that other characters would be different. Yeah. So the different story has to come. Now, probable storyline could be that one character might not be following Scrum because he don't see a value in it, and he find it's too much overhead. And then we told him that just follow it for 2 months, and if that doesn't work and he doesn't get any value, then drop it. Then we had an agreement with him, and he tried for 2 months, and after that he liked the idea, and it worked. That could be a one story path, and there could be a one experience like that. Another experience could be that, okay, I have been influencing this guy for a while, and I realize that he's very resistive in following Agile and Scrum. Then I realized to leave him alone, and I stopped bugging him, and we dealt him the way he wanted to work. But at the same time, we started exposing things which he was losing because of not attending all the Scrum events and not engaging with our Scrum teams. So I stopped pushing on him. But I keep reminding occasionally the gaps which he might be facing because of not following it. And over a period of time, he started liking the idea, and then he himself came to you and says, "Okay, I also want to be a part of this whole thing." That could be a second storyline.
Okay, but in this case, just a question. So in this case, if a person is reluctant, if we are leaving him alone the way he wants to work, so in that case, will it not going to impact the velocity or overall functionality of a development team within a sprint? Because definitely it will going to reduce the number of stories they are picking in because they are dependent on him.
Yeah, so something like this. So not following Scrum means he doesn't want it to come to daily Scrum. Whenever he come to, he says, "I will send an email. I will not come to daily Scrum." So
Right.
okay, let's work with email, and I will work personally with you for a while. Something like that. Or he started saying that, "I don't want to attend retrospective."
Okay.
Okay, so we said okay. Rather than pushing him to attend retrospective, he says, "Okay, don't attend. If you have an input, give it to us, and then later on we will tell if you have an action or observation about your work." And then over a period of time, you started providing those feedbacks that this is what we have discussed in retrospective, and this is what has come to you towards you. And he said, "Oh, I would ha I also had a point here." He said, "Oh, you missed the point. You were not there. What do we do?"
Right.
Something like that. So it's like that we figure it out how to deal with the guy without pushing him to follow each and every ceremony. Say he one person could be very resistive in saying, "I am not going to self-assign work to me. You assign work to me." Say, "Okay, I will
Right.
assign work for it to you." Rest of the guys started picking up the work, but for this guy, I used to assign the work. But in between, I started also highlighting the thing that what better could have been done if he would have picked on his own. So over a period of time, he started liking that idea.
Got
So
it, got
something
it.
like that. So, but it has to be clubbed in a character and stories.
Right.
That's the thing. And then you need to bring a tentativeness that, okay, each person is different and things might There could be a situation where you end up leaving the guy because there are many cases. Somebody was sharing his story in one of the Scrum team. He was saying there was a one guy, he was not following anything and he was becoming always problem in the team, but he was so much influential. He was the most senior guy. We tried to ignore him for a while, but nothing worked out. And one day team came together and they went to the delivery manager. Either you keep this guy or you keep us. Only one person can work in this team. And finally, they decided to remove that guy. Right. So that could be also a reality. So all these three things could be reality, but you need to pick up something which matches with your profile, which matches with your work environment. And then you can tell. If it is not directly and you find it difficult to have it in your profile, then you may bring it something which you might have observed. He says, okay, I had a fellow Scrum Master who faced this problem. Okay. So if you say that it is very becoming difficult for me to have it, you can say, okay, I can share one story.